knows a lot about all kinds of stuff. Professor Dave Explains.
Throughout this series, we've developed a diverse range of tools for solving all the different types of ordinary differential equations. There is one more such tool that we should know about that finds use in many fields of applied math, including electrical engineering and control theory, and that is the Laplace transform. The Laplace transform is an operator that takes some function, say f of t, and returns another function of a different variable, traditionally written capital F of s, where s is a new variable that is generally a complex number and can be written as s equals sigma plus I omega. This operator is defined as the improper integral from 0 to infinity of f of t times e to the negative st dt, and it's usually only defined for functions where the argument t is real and non-negative. For any given real-valued function, its Laplace transform is therefore a complex-valued function of the complex variable s. We can represent the magnitude of the Laplace transform as a multivariable function. On axes of the real part of s, sigma, and the imaginary part of s, omega. Values of s for which the improper integral diverges to infinity are known as pole points, while the values of s for which the integral is zero is a zero point. Often we are only interested in where these pole and zero points lie, and the rest of the function is irrelevant, so we mark zero points with circles and pole points with x's, and this plot in the s domain is the pole zero plot for the function. The purpose of using Laplace transforms in our study of differential equations is that when we apply the Laplace transform to both sides of a differential equation, we will actually end up with an algebraic equation in the s domain. This equation is very easy to solve for our transformed dependent variable, and then we can invert the transform to recover the solution to the differential equation. First, let's take a look at the Laplace transforms of some common functions, shown in this table of transforms. In the left column, we can see that constants, polynomials, trig functions, hyperbolic functions, exponentials, and all of their products all end up transforming to some rational function of s. In the right column, we can see the Heaviside step function u of t, which is a piecewise function with the value 1 for positive t and 0 for negative t, and also the Dirac delta function, delta of t, which is a special function that can't be written down nicely, but will be extremely useful as we will see in the next tutorial. Most important for now are the transforms of the first and second derivatives of f of t, shown in the bottom right of the table, where derivatives in t are converted to polynomials in s. This essentially means that first-order DEs will become linear equations, second-order DEs will become quadratic equations, and so forth. Let's see an example. Suppose we want to solve the non-homogeneous second-order DE y double prime plus y prime minus 2y equals cosine of t with initial conditions y of 0 is 0 and y prime of 0 is 1. We will apply the Laplace transform operator to both sides of this equation, exploiting the fact that it is a linear operator, so we can transform the terms individually and factor out the constant coefficients. Looking at our table of Laplace transforms, we can transform the y double prime of t term into s squared times capital Y of s, minus s times y of 0, minus y prime of 0, where capital Y is the Laplace transform of our solution y of t. Similarly, we can transform y prime of t into s times capital Y of s, minus y of 0, and the y of t term just becomes capital Y of s by definition. On the other side, the table gives the transform of cosine of t as s over the quantity s squared plus 1. We can now write out our transformed equation, s squared times capital Y plus s times capital Y minus 2 capital Y minus 1 equals s over s squared plus 1. This is a purely algebraic equation, and with a little factoring and rearranging, we can solve for y, expressing it as a rational function of s with three simple factors in the denominator. Since this is our transformed solution, we need to take the inverse Laplace transform to obtain our solution in the time domain. This function doesn't appear in our table, so we need to manipulate it in such a way that we can easily read off the transforms. Partial fraction decomposition is often the best way to achieve this, which converts a factorized rational function into a sum of irreducible algebraic functions. Skipping the algebra, we can apply partial fractions to our transform capital Y of S to get the following expression. Each of these four terms appears in the table of transforms, and we can just write down the solution term by term, which is 1/2 e to the t minus 1/5 e to the minus 2 t plus 1/10 sine t minus 3/10 cosine t. Notice that this gave us both the complementary solution and the particular integral and the unknown coefficients, all in one go. So it should be clear that the Laplace transform is a very powerful technique. Laplace transforms can also be used to solve systems of differential equations. If we have a system with two dependent variables in two differential equations, we can take both of their Laplace transforms, and we will end up with a 2x2 system of simultaneous equations in the S domain. This can be solved using normal algebra techniques, such as elimination, to get functions for the transformed solutions, and inverting each one separately gives the solutions to the system. You might be wondering if there's any way to do this without using the table. In most differential equations classes, you will be given the table of transforms to help you speed up the calculations, but otherwise you'll need to memorize them or derive them each time with the integral formula shown at the start. When taking inverse transforms, the table is key. Although there does exist an integral formula for calculating the inverse Laplace transform of a function, it is defined as an improper line integral in the complex plane, which requires techniques from a field of higher math known as complex analysis, which is not the focus of this series. Knowing or having access to the table is realistically the only way to solve differential equations with Laplace transforms. Let's check comprehension.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.